what's the takeaway from a draw in a game that had just about everything except for the win for you guys?
A point. I'm proud of the group and the work they put in to get the point and create a couple of chances and have to deal with the referee. And, you know, I'm not saying, you know, until the red card, I felt we had the game in hand a little bit. It was just one of those days, but we could have easily dropped all 3 points. So it shows the character of the group. You know, we were up a player last week and didn't get any points. We were down a player this week and got a point. So, you know, the players represented the jersey well. They battled, they competed for each other, and, you know, give up a goal on a set piece. So, but I'm proud of the group for battling and competing in these conditions and so on. So, yeah, you can take the point and move on.
I thought Nahas looked really, really good for her debut. What do you think?
Yeah, she's great, but once the system went out of whack, she wasn't able to get on the ball as much. Couldn't find her in free spaces. She's lively, but, you know, the first 15 minutes or whatever it was, she was live. I mean, she was unbelievable. But then once we lose our key pieces of what we need to do, it's really hard. And, you know, people say, oh, plan B, plan C, plan D. It's hard to plan for that, and you have to plan for a referee too. So, yeah, I mean, I think overall it's, there's a lot for her to build off of, but yeah, she's gonna be a good one.
Talking about the conditions out there, you had that lengthy delay in the first half. How detrimental was that in terms of getting your flow back?
I mean, you can say that, or you can say that we needed the rest of the time, you know? So, yeah, I mean, I felt we had the ball before that, and then, you know, they came out and started throwing St. George's at us, and once St. George's was taken out, that helped us out, because she was, with all due respect, she was having a go at Kiki. So that helped us a little bit. But yeah, I mean, those breaks, they're good for some, good for others, but at that stage, I think we needed a break, but it's hard to get revved back up down a player to muster that up again. So yeah, I mean, both teams had to deal with it for sure.
How do you feel you guys defended being down 10 minutes for
we drew. We're gonna lose. You tell me. Not mean to be rude, but, you know, I'm not the happiest person right now in terms of a lot of things that we had to deal with, decisions we made on the ball, you know, especially in these moments. But yeah, look, normally we don't see a lot of defending from us because we have the ball a lot, and if anything, it shows that when we compete and do those things, we can still defend, and we needed to tonight. You know, we didn't have the ball a lot in the second half, if at all, and the game became transitional for us, and we're not a trend. We don't have the players to transition. So yeah, I mean, like I said before, I'm really proud of the group. It was a complete effort, and I told the group at halftime, unfortunately, some of the players that maybe we planned on getting in, we weren't going to be able to. I didn't want to take Tess out, but we had to put a back in. We couldn't go three in the back. So, like I said, the group was brilliant in resolve and character and just found a way. Who knows, maybe this 1 point, we'll look back on it and say it was a massive 1 point.
What did the refs tell you during the weather delay, and have you ever been through a heat delay like that before?
Tell us anything? I mean, nothing. We knew going in what the situation was. It was just they were waiting for the humidity to drop. That's all we knew. It's not about, I would like the referees to communicate with us more on the sidelines about some of the decisions or lack thereof. But the fourth official didn't want to speak. He just gave me the smug coach one. And I haven't spoken about referees at all this year, but in these type of games, at this stage, it has to be better. It was so inconsistent on both sides. Some of the calls that were being made, I don't even know what they were calling. They weren't even fouls both ways. I'm just talking about us, talking about both ways. But that's part of it. And then when you go up after the game and ask the fourth official why you're not communicating with us, and we get an answer of, you know, that's not his job. That is his job. His job is to communicate with us, and he didn't do that.
Was there a particular call that...
Everyone.
Any other questions in the room?
I was just going to briefly switch gears. You made some comments earlier this week about what's going on with the Spanish women's national team.
Yeah.
What are your thoughts right now on where they're at with, you know, investigating or not investigating?
I can't speak on the investigation, but I can speak on the support for the players. You know, I think it's, I said this, there doesn't have to be an investigation. It was done on live TV. I mean, it's, what investigating do you have to do? It's right there for everyone to see. But it's funny now because you look at it and you see the coach now not supporting the president. But is that because he doesn't have his support anymore because he's suspended? So does he feel like he's a lame duck and he's got to now speak out against them? But there's obviously something wrong. And what it shows me is those players won the World Cup because of them, meaning the players, because of the team. And we as a club fully support it. The players, Hermoso, all of them. You know, I think it's, we should be celebrating the football that they played. We should be supporting the level of football that they played. We should be supporting the fact they won their first World Cup. I haven't heard a single word about it since this whole thing went down, and I think that's a shame. And I think as media, yeah, we need to talk about it, but we need to talk about what these players did because they dominated the World Cup in a beautiful fashion. So hopefully FIFA does their job. Hopefully UEFA speaks up. I haven't heard them say anything. And you know, you hear some of these other coaches overseas talk about saying it is a big deal, and hopefully the players get what they deserve, and them not wanting to join the national team until something changes, I think that's brilliant, because the players have there's no federation without the players, and that federation are the world champions in all three age groups. So someone needs to open their eyes and realize, but there shouldn't be an investigation. It's live on TV. There's your investigation. You should be done.
In terms of the whole systemic change that very clearly needs to happen, from your point of view, where do we start with that? Where do we pick up with that to support these players before it even gets to, you know, a federation president?
Yeah, I mean, it's people, it's hard to say. I mean, you know, I don't like to speak about what happened in our league, but, you know, I think you can't predict it. You know, you have people that when they're in those positions, they feel that, look, it's not even the kiss, it's the celebrating revenues, you know, and it's just so many different things that just came all out in that moment. And the arrogance to not resign when you say you're gonna resign and act defiant, like it's like a dictator, you know? I feel like they were going to war or something. And, you know, people talking, oh, women were clapping. And they were clapping because they were put in a position where they had no choice. You know, if you listen to what the technical staff said, they didn't want to sit there. They were told they had to sit there. That's what I read, at least. But it's so hard to, you can't predict these things, unfortunately, and you know, all you can do is do as much as you possibly can to filter it. But you know, I think at the end of the day, you can have as many processes as you possibly can. It's when the camera's not watching, what do? But hell, the camera was on. Look what they did. So maybe when Putellas and all them were saying 2 years ago this was going on, obviously they weren't lying.
Jordan, question via Zoom. Okay. Sean, thank you.
Thank you, Sean. Thank you, Sean.